오늘의 환상 특급은 이제 막 출근한 의사 레슬리의 특별한 치료법에 대한 이야기입니다.
I don't want a shot. I want the flu.
You look like a pretty healthy little girl. Look at these nails.
Ooh.
Oh, gorgeous. What color is that?
Primrose.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Hey, you tricked me.
Because it's my job to keep you from getting the flu. But we don't have to do this for a whole another year. Gotta how you keep your cool. Must be that 100 grand in student loans I'm still paying off.
Excuse me, sir. Can I help you?
You cannot help me. I need Dr. Coburn immediately.
Harry, Rhonda is new here, so at least try to be polite.
I'll be in room 3. Time is of the essence.
Harry Radich. Proud member of the Disease of the Month Club. He had TB as a child. I guess he just got used to all the attention. Well, Harry's never manifested any symptoms, so I just give him a placebo. He has a remarkable recovery rate. What seems to be the problem today?
You'll tell me it's all in my mind.
Why don't you tell me your symptoms? You seem to have ruptured a blood vessel in your sclera. You had any trauma to the eye?
It's only the tip of the iceberg.
Harry, what are you doing?
Look at that. I don't think that's gonna clot. I think I could bleed to death.
We're gonna get this bleeding under control. In the meantime, I'm gonna run some tests.
Dr. Leslie Coburn has always treated Harry with a placebo, an imaginary cure for his imaginary illnesses. But what will this young doctor do when her patient contracts a real disease? A disease found only in the Twilight Zone.
곧바로 해리의 혈액을 검사해 보는데 아무런 이상도 발견되지 않습니다.
Well, actually, it's Harry Raddick.
Treat the mind, not the body.
This time he's exhibiting symptoms, but aside from the blood anomaly, he's got some very unusual skin masses.
My advice, refer him to a psychiatrist.
But isn't it possible he may have actually contracted something real?
Tell you what, makes you feel any better? Run some more tests.
같은 시각 해리는 병원에서 떠날 준비를 하고 있었는데요.
Planning on staying a while, Harry?
With what little time I have left, I'd rather not be mocked.
Listen, you gotta get that cut sealed up. Have you traveled out of the country recently?
I'd like to travel. I was always afraid of picking up some rare disease. I rarely leave my house anymore. Mrs. Mendelsohn, my housekeeper, she even does all my shopping for me. Mrs. Mendelsohn? What if I've given her the disease? What if she's spreading it? The bubonic plague started like
Harry,
this!
Please, calm down. This could be nothing more than an allergic reaction. I just need to run a few more tests.
Doctor, there's something you should know. Your optimism, it's contagious.
I need you to fax this to the CDC.
So does Fruitcake. He's a book dealer? I can just imagine what kind of books he sells.
Wake up, Harry. You still must get books from all over the world by mail. What are you not telling me, Harry?
But you're not going to believe it. The answer to all this is a book. It's not the way you think.
Mission to Zebulon?
My virus? It's not from this Earth.
From planet Zebulon?
No, it's from the book. The story. Read the back cover.
This is ridiculous.
Please, just read it.
The mission to Zebulon takes a disastrous turn when crew members contract a hostile virus whose first stage symptoms include uncontrollable bleeding and a strange pattern of black skin protrusions. Their only hope is to find an antidote, something that will reverse the process before the virus starts purging all the blood from the bodies of its victims. What I can't believe is that I actually took you seriously this time. I'm calling County Psych Ward. I'm having a transfer.
그때 또 다른 환자가 들어오는데
Code Blue!
해리의 증상과 똑같았습니다.
Her name's Elise Mendelsohn. It's Harry's housekeeper. She's dead. Just like him. How do you spread a fictional disease?
그리고 레슬리도 감염된 것 같네요.
How do you cure a fictional disease?
Well, kids on the truck.
How long do we have to stay in here?
Until we know if you're contagious.
It's a contact virus, but they can't classify it any further. Origin's unknown.
Anyone else manifested symptoms?
No. Thankfully, just me.
I'm on my way.
You didn't tell him about the book.
How could I?
They told me about Mrs. Mendelsohn.
And I don't have much time.
No, not you too.
Why didn't you tell me about the book from the beginning?
You know, you're the only doctor that ever showed me any respect.
Tell me everything, Harry. From the start, how it happened.
I was reading the book last night. The story was so haunting, so I couldn't get it out of my head. I wish I never woke up this morning. Please forgive me.
레슬리의 증상이 심해지던 상황. 감염된 환자가 더 늘어나는 중인데요.
I don't want to die like that housekeeper.
I am going to do everything I can to beat this.
How did they beat it in that book?
They didn't.
So we're going to die because some lousy writer couldn't come up with a happy ending?
That might be it. Harry convinced himself that he had the virus in that book. Just like he's convinced himself he's had a dozen other diseases. Only this time, he made it real. His imagination brought the virus to life. Maybe all we have to do is use his imagination to create a cure.
It's the placebo effect. An imaginary illness calls for an imaginary cure.
We are going to rewrite the ending to this story, a happy ending. Did you read about the meteor shower last night?
Yes.
A meteor actually hit Earth early this morning. It hit North Dakota. They felt it all the way to Arizona.
Single meteor was responsible for killing off the dinosaur. Would bring on an ice age in a matter of hours. A total disaster.
It is not a disaster. It's a miracle.
I don't understand.
Found residue at the meteor strike site that they believe contains a rare element that may be virucidal. You are the key to this thing. If you don't test this vaccine, everyone in this building might die. So trust me.
Just do it fast.
그렇게 해리가 치료제를 맞은 후 시간이 흐르는데요.
Leslie.
Dr. Leslie Coburn had a brilliant idea. But like the virus itself, Harry took her cure to heart, and he made it real. Testament to the amazing powers of the mind in the Twilight Zone.
영상 제작에 큰 힘이 되는 구독, 좋아요, 댓글 부탁드릴게요.